Here with promoter Joe DeGuardia, 27,000 miles later, you literally circled the globe before the New York News Conference, Pacquiao, Jerry. Last 2 weeks, how's that been?
Oh, it's been fantastic. It's the kind of ride you want to be on. 27,000 miles, 2 weeks, multiple cities, tons and tons of, you know, fans that know the game and, you know, love the fighters. And frankly, to be with Manny Pacquiao, who's a great ambassador for the sport, a congressman, and Chris Algieri, who certainly is a fantastic example for the fans and for youth of what you can do both in and out of the ring. It's fantastic.
You literally have seen, I guess, the growth of the awareness for this event worldwide. I mean, how is it, you know, kind of snowballed upwards into right now? A lot of people are talking about this fight.
Oh, it's fantastic. Look, in November, I was talking about Chris Algieri when he was going to fight Emmanuel Taylor in that fight in February. And people didn't really give him a shot in that fight, but it mushroomed out. He won the fight, won every round. Then in June, when we were going to fight Ruslan Provodnikov, everybody said, no way. And people started to believe. They saw him fight. They saw the heart, determination, the fire in this technical fighter. And now that ball keeps snowballing out even bigger. And it's just great to see, because November 22nd, you're going to see it get even bigger, the explosion.
Now these guys have been face-to-face 5-6 times. I know fights aren't won and lost in stare-downs or press conferences. Is there anything that you see maybe physically that, you know, maybe tilts the advantage more in Chris's favor?
Now look, it's been... Certainly, obviously, you look at the physical advantages, height, reach, things like that. And, you know, it's been a great, great run. They've been having a lot of competitions on the road between bowling and pool and basketball and baseball.
Those stats haven't got out. Who's winning those?
Oh, well, listen, it doesn't tell what's going to happen in the fight. But Chris has been winning all of them. Manny always starts off winning, and then Chris ends up taking it at the end.
Could this be a microcosm what we may see on November 22nd?
It just may be. You know what? It's a microcosm what we saw on June 14th with the Ruslan fight when he got dropped twice in the first, came back, eye closed, won the fight. And it's been what's been going on in the friendly competitions between the two of them. But truthfully, when all is said and done, it's going to matter what happens in that ring on November 22nd. And I believe that Chris has the will, determination, and fire in him, and he wants to be a winner.
Based on some of the press conferences I've seen, your kind of platform, so to speak, is Chris Algieri, the great American story. Get into that for a little bit.
Oh, it's a feel-good story. It's the American dream. Here you are, you have a kid who went last year fighting on our shows at the Paramount in his hometown, sure selling out, sure creating a buzz, but not on a national scale, not making big money. Okay, he goes, fights on ESPN, wins a big fight in February. Goes into HBO and fights Ruslan Provodnikov. Makes enough money to finally pay off his student loans, which he does. And now, the biggest fight on the biggest platform in the world. Manny Pacquiao, the Venetian in Macau. November 22nd, pay-per-view. It's the American dream.
You said it real quickly. You mentioned Emmanuel Taylor, 48 hours. He's got a big fight. You'll be in Cincinnati, I would imagine.
Yeah, we have Saturday, Cincinnati. Emmanuel Taylor versus Adrian Bruner. Rooting for Emmanuel Taylor, looking for him to pull up another one, beat Bruner, and go on to bigger and better things.
What's another of the 600-700 miles for you through the air, you know, while we're at it?
They become quick and easy rides now, right?
Yeah.
The flight from L.A. to New York, it wasn't that bad because you get used to going around the world.
We're here to Cincinnati. It's going to feel like a car ride next door.
It'll be a short hop. It'll be all right.
Well, best of luck Saturday night. Best of luck November 22nd, Jeff.
Thank you, Mark.
Thank you.